forms an effect in the physical world, although of course many soul formations are linked to those of the other world. The human soul, for example, is linked to the human physical body and to the human spirit, and is obviously observable and interdependent by both the physical and spiritual world. We must take this into account when observing the soul world, and we must not make the mistake of attributing to a knowledge of soul world that is actually due to the influence of one of the other worlds. For example, when a wish received from a human being, it is carried by a thought, a spiritual conception, whose laws it obeys. Just as we can establish what the laws of the physical world are by disregarding the influence human beings have on its processes, for example, we can do something similar with the soul world. 9. We can express an important difference between soul and physical processes by saying that the interaction between soul processes is much more inward. In physical space, for instance, the law of impact is in effect. If a moving ivory ball strikes another one at rest, the second ball moves in a direction that can be calculated from the motion and elasticity of the first. In soul space, however, the interaction between two formations does not depend on their inner attributes. If they are related, they interpenetrate and grow together, so to speak. If their essential natures are in conflict, they repel each other. To take another example, certain laws govern the way we see things in physical space, distant objects appear reduced. The three roads run under three. 5. When you look down a long streamlined street, you see that the laws of perspective appear closer together than the ones in the foreground. Within soul space, all things, near and far, appear to be observer distances from one another that are determined by their inner nature. Of course, this can be the source of any number of errors for anyone who enters soul space and tries to get a long moving unit drawn from the physical world.
The kind of activity meant here is evident. For instance, when the soul is
received a sensation of color. If I have a sensation of a red color, I am receiving a stimulus from my surroundings. A stimulus can be useful to begin with. Only when my light infrared is added to the stimulus is another cool activity into the picture. The need for stimulus is caused by cool formation in which a balanced interaction between sensitivity and antipathy is maintained. We must describe the soul self-serving question as clearly now as it is going. When it moves through soul state, it is not self-centered like the first sight. It is just as it's functional and effective to affection, but it's still the emotions of collecting what comes from others. Strobe sensitivity is a term that might be applied to the second sight. In the third sight of soul formation, sympathy predominates over antipathy. Antipathy brings about self-centered self-assertion. In this case, however, it seems that in place the inclination for things in the surrounding.
In the first three regions, soul formation
electricity becomes ever freer. The soul substance is a deep highest reason drops through soul state, enlightening and enlivening, awakening what mood, is left to itself, moves itself in its own existence. Although it should be unnecessary to mention it by now, let us emphasize for the sake of clarity that these seven divisions of the soul world do not represent distinct and separate areas. Just as solid, fluid and gaseous substances intermingle in the physical world, burning desires, strong sensitivity and the forces of the soul world begin to penetrate the soul world. On the physical level, it penetrates and light shines on bodies. In the soul world, the same thing happens with pleasure and displeasure, and with soul light. Something similar is also true of active soul power and soul light. The three worlds 109. 2. The soul and the soul world after death. The human soul is the connecting link between the human spirit and the human body. This forces of sympathy and antipathy, which further interplay bring about the soul's expressions of desire, sensitivity, wish, pleasure and displeasure, and so on, are not only active in these soul formations, but also express themselves in relations of these beings of the other world, the physical and the spiritual. While the soul is living in a body, it participates to some degree in everything that goes on in this body. Functions of the physical body are proceeding smoothly, pleasure and comfort arise in the soul, but when these functions are disturbed, pleasure and pain appear. But the soul also takes part in the spirit's activity. One thought feels with its soul, another with distrust, it is called to correct judgment and disapprove of a false one. A person's level of development depends on whether his or her soul leans more in the one direction or in another. Individuals of a more nearly perfect, the more discreet synthesized with manifestations of the spirit, the less perfect, the more their soul's inclinations are satisfied through bodily functions. The spirit is at the center of each human being, and the body is the instrument through which the spirit of the person knows, and also acts in, the physical world. The soul, however, mediates between the two. For example, it releases the sensation of tone from the physical impressions that air vibrations make on the ear, and then it experiences pleasure in its tone. It imparts all this to the spirit, which 16, 17, 110 theosophies, losing its understanding of the physical world as a result. A thought that appears in the spirit is converted by the soul into the lucid brain the thought into being,